demonstration of it. Go do it again to me. We just made a sale, and just spend 30 seconds doing a cigarette close with me.
Hey, Claude, man, I cannot wait to see you get started in the next, 90 days, earning enough passive income to retire your wife so she could stay home with your six chihuahuas.
Only five.
Okay. Oh, my bad. with hair like
we got another chihuahua.
with hair like that, you seem like you're a man of your word. You're not going to call me tomorrow.
I need a haircut real bad, don't I?
you're not going to call me tomorrow and break my heart and tell me that your wife thought about this and she thinks it's a bad idea that Joe McCall's cheaper, right?
Oh, no. I've taken Joe's course. It's great. But, man, I'm really – no, I wouldn't do that to you. No, I'm a man of my word.
You seem like it. Well, I'm super excited to get you, to your goals that you want to see. You told me Rhonda, she wants to be retired in the next 90 days. A man like you is very decisive. I can tell because we came to such a decision so quickly. So let's go. I'm going to send you a calendar link. I can't wait to do your hour jumpstart.
Okay. So, Michael, do you see if you spend that extra 30 seconds? I always say sales is dangerous because when you go to the guy, are you sure about this? I can still rip up the credit card. I can still rip up the contract. You're not going to call me tomorrow. I mean, I'm so looking, you stroke and nurture, but you also say the one thing your competition will never say. Mr. Prospect, you're not going to change your mind or call me tomorrow. Or we came to this decision really quickly. I'm so happy we're doing business, but are you comfortable with this decision? These are the moves that really great salespeople do. And you never get that cancellation next day stuff from them. You really won't if you make that small move. Okay. Did we beat that to death, Michael? Okay. Yeah, it's a really good move. Chris, you brought up something before. What happens when we make a sale, we're getting close to a sale, and we're real happy, and we start getting emotionally involved in the sale? Can we lose? And we stop. You said something about you skip some of the moves sometimes.
Yeah,
we jump around a little. Is that because we got emotional and this starts shutting off a little bit?
Absolutely. You start taking what they're saying for face value and you're like, I don't need to follow the process. These guys are bought in. They love me,
Yeah.
And then you skip it.
Yeah. Frank, you want to chime in on this, Mr. Iglesias?
Well, I haven't had that happen with a coaching client yet, but the concept in general, yes, it's very easy to hear someone that's excited and then all of a sudden their mind goes blah, and then they're gone, or they got to think about it or ask the entire family and their dead loved ones and everything.
Yeah, we can. Here's the danger in sales is we can become emotional. When we become emotional, we start jumping around. We start lose control of the conversation and the process. We can act enthusiastic. Don't people love enthusiasm? Alex, don't your clients love it when you're as enthusiastic as they are?
Yeah, 100%.
Right.
Yeah, it's infectious. It transfers.
Yeah, but you're still inside, aren't you? Thinking, okay, what do I got to do next? I need a contract. I need to get a payment. I need to work out financing. You've got to keep that in line in your head, even though you're enthusiastic.
Yeah. I think it's a fine line. I think you still have to stick to your process and your system, but you can still show enthusiasm without getting overly emotional.
I forgot who said it. Sales trainer said, enthusiasm sells. If you're calling up people and talking, hi, how are you? Just reaching out, just want to talk to you about my product, my service, how great lease purchasing is and everything. If you talk in a monotone drone with no passion, it's going to be hard to close somebody like that, isn't it?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. How about, when you meet somebody who's more of a left brain thinker, more of a scientist, more of a mathematical person, what do they want from other people? The same personality? or a little bit of voom energy? What about if you're having a bad day and you got a prospect, a hot prospect calling you? How should you act?
Like you're not having a bad day.
Yeah. Can you flip the switch? You're having a really, pardon my language, a shitty Monday. Okay. What was that one song? I don't like Mondays. Who did that? Trivia question. I don't like Mondays. Who did that song? It's an old 70s or 80s song. Randy, you know these things. Somebody go.
Mamas and the Papas.
Thank you. Was it? Okay. No, they did Monday. Can't trust that day. Yeah. Somebody sing it for me. No, don't sing it. Let's go back to my mind here. Too much fun here. Where's my mind map? There. Find it here. Let's go here. Okay. It's instinctual. It's a gut feeling. The magic moment. You have the momentum, you have laughter, positive statements from the prospect. You got to use that a little bit of that. We talk about it. I got a book coming out this year, Gut 6.0, Hypnotic Selling. You want to get commitments. You want to use words like, or statements like, hey, Mrs. Prospect, imagine for a moment, Mr. Prospect, Mr. Pardo, how would you feel? Can you see yourself on the beach, the sand between your toes, the salt air, the palm trees flowing, the barbecue in the back with the sizzling steak and the melting butter? And should we add bacon to that? You know, okay. You know, you gotta put a picture in their mind sometimes. How would you feel, sir, if I could give you the, if I could be a part of this process to get you there in the next 6 months? How do you feel about that, sir? Boom. You've got to create a magic moment sometimes. Okay, Mr. Prospect, you wouldn't want to take an action today if we could help you to move forward, achieve those goals, those 3 to 6 needs and greeds that you were telling, those things.